go from last time. So, as your host, remember last time you managed to escape from Brandscar Prison? You're the first group ever to do so.
Yeah. Last time
And you did so with the help of your newfound friend, Grumblejack the Ogre.
Yeah.
There was a ton of loot. Most of it very repetitive. So any time if any of you want any of the chainmail stuff, there's about 16 different 16 chain shirts, heavy shields, daggers and long swords and stuff. You can arm yourself to the teeth with those. The slightly more valuable things, I know a few people claimed some bobs.
Who claimed the brand first? I know I claimed I wanted it, but who else wanted it?
I think I also claimed it, but I don't mind the I can share.
Yeah, sure. Because I want to use that to cover our
tracks.
Yeah,
me too.
So the other thing, there was a couple of rings. One of them worth 250 gold, the other one only worth 1 gold. Are you happy to just carry them in a general party loot bag and then sell them at some point and divide the money up between the four of you?
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, that sounds reasonable.
Yeah.
Okay, so the Masterwork Longsword?
I claimed that. Yeah, took it.
Okay. Yep. Alright, then we had the Great Sword. I think one suggestion was that Grumblejack could use that as essentially a longsword.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty much. That's what I said.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Anyone got any objections to that?
What mm-hmm. one is that?
That's the Great Sword, two-handed sword.
Yeah, sure.
And we've got a rapier, battle axe, spear, heavy mace, dagger, and glaive. If I didn't say that already. And, yeah, you've got 16 longbows. Anyone want to claim any of those weapons?
No, not really.
I did a dagger.
You've got a ton of enough lantern oil to do whatever you want with. I think there's some suggestion about burning the entire place down.
That was me.
Yep.
Last time
there's certainly enough lantern oil to do that.
Yeah, last time I checked, we really fucked that place over.
Yep, I've got my notes on that. I think that's pretty much everything. Oh, and you've all got 50 foot of rope.
Yes.
And you can have another 50 foot of rope if you want that as well.
Hang on, I haven't got that on my sheet. Rope. Quantity. Yeah, well, 50 feet, was it?
Yeah.
Okay. And how much does it weigh?
I don't have.
Is it like 10 pounds or something?
Yeah, yes. 10 pounds, 50 foot of rope. There's 20 50 foot sections of rope, so you can have as many 50 foot sections of rope as you want, essentially.
It can't be too heavy. It's just rope.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, but I've only got 10 strength, so I've got to watch it.
Oh, okay. I guess I'm the strongest member of the party, apart from Grumblejack, I guess.
Why, how much strength do you have?
I've got 18. I guess carrying books all day really buffs you up.
No, I've got 17, so I'm one behind you.
Yeah, you can increase that. Like at level 4.
Grumblejack has strength 21.
Yeah, he would.
Yeah.
Hello, hello.
Other than that, there's a huge pile of old books, which I believe...
I'm gonna put them in a sack I'm gonna put them in a sack and carry as many as I can.
Yep.
without going over medium load.
Yeah. I think in total there are 600 pounds worth of books, as in, yeah, 600 pounds weight of books.
Holy crap.
Okay, I can carry about 150 pounds of books then.
Okay.
Roughly.
Yep.
Oh, and I've taken up sort of a scouty position at the front door, like, over the 2 days. Just to keep an eye out, see if anyone's coming.
I've been doing...
Okay. Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
I've been doing fucked up things, burning all the furniture, you know, all the normal stuff.
So, I think that's all of the bookkeeping from last time. So, any of the weapons that you don't need, are you just piling them onto Grumblejack and cutting them around with you?
The only things I took were a rapier, a longbow, and arrows.
Okay, yeah, fine.
I'm gonna want a quarterstaff later, but I don't need it just yet.
Tell me when you need it, because I have it.
Yeah, I'm gonna get another one. It's really cheap. It, like, costs no money.
Yeah. So, the other things, there are a significant number of chain shirts, heavy steel shields and long swords, leather whips and long bows, all with Randerskar prison crest engraved on them. Are you taking those with you?
Would we be able to get Grumblecheck to hold some of it?
Yeah, if you're happy to, I just pile all the excess crap onto him, then I can work that out another time when we, and let you know how much it sells for when you're next able to
do that.
Sounds good.
Okay, right. So, after a few days, after 2 days, you're now 1 day away for, this is now the morning of your supposed execution.
Yes, we should probably leave.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay.
We leave immediately.
Yep, in the... desk of the captain, as well as finding a significant amount of gold that he was taking out of prison funds. You also found a map which shows the local area, including the mansion that you're meant to be going to.
Okay, that's good.
It appears there's two ways. Yep, so also not mansion, probably the manor house. Sorry, there you go. There appears there's two ways to get there. You can go along the main road, or you can go through the marshland.
What way is it again?
If we went...
So there's the main road and the marshland. Both of those...
I say we go marshland, because if we go main road, it would be too risky.
I was just gonna say, if we went... during the night, then we could have tried the road, but since it's obviously morning already, we better take the marshland.
Yeah, what does the road look like? Is it covered in forest, or... I mean, you know, does it look like there are places to hide, basically?
Yep, it's a fairly large road, as it goes eventually down to the capital. So it's a it links the capital up to the rest of Talengard. So it's a wide road, well used. But there's, in this particular place, there's forest, and it's fairly close to marshland anyway.
So we could take the road and just hide in bushes and stuff along it if we see anyone coming.
Yep, from the map you've got that, looks like you'd be able to do it.
It's still risky, though.
I put that suggestion to the party just because it's going to seriously speed up things. I'm pretty sure marshland is, like, difficult terrain or whatever, so we'll be moving at, like, half speed or something.
Yep. Overall, it looks roughly... it'd take roughly about the same amount of time. The... Sorry. I'll just draw a quick sketch. So, the... You are there. The road travels up and then down to the south, which is relevant for you, and then goes off to the north. The manor house is there. This part is the marshland. So basically, you either go up the road,
okay,
and then
Taking the road would be quicker, but also longer, is what you're saying.
It would take roughly the same amount of time. The road is longer.
Yes, but it would be longer. Yeah. Yeah.
It's twice as far, but you can travel twice as fast, essentially.
I don't know. I just find it more risky if we go to the main road. If it's like this, then I say we
we stay out of sight for now. Just go through the marsh.
Yeah, I agree.
Because this is the day when we're going to get executed, right? So they're going to come from the main road. So we really shouldn't risk it.
Yep. I say we go through the marsh.
Okay.
Oh, no way.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay, has anyone got survival?
No.
No,
I've got a +4 in it, but hang that's on. What I have.
Okay, yeah, that sounds like...
That's fine.
Not really. No.
Okay, well, it sounds like we've got person in charge. It's not a particularly difficult check. If you make a...
Well, I'm rolling
survival
it.
Check. Yep, so I couldn't quite work out who that was.
What is it?
Four,
D20?
D20 plus E4, yeah.
Plus 4, go. 10.
Yeah, that's fine. With the help of the map, you manage to find your way across the marsh, or across most of the marshland. You think you're going in the right direction. It's difficult to navigate too clearly because it all looks very similar. But could I have and everyone can take this, what's the opposite of a hide check?
Perception?
Perception, that's one.
Perception?
Let me look at my perception.
Well, I can certainly try that.
I've no idea what my perception is, sorry. Where is it? Oh, it's a +4 again.
14! That's pretty 10. Good considering I have -1.
10.
Yep, brilliant. Slain.
20.
Holy shit!
And Gregory, nicely done.
You see everything.
You see everything.
Slain and Gregory.
Forever.
Ahead is a sort of a small patch of particularly boggy ground. You thought you saw something, but it pop up out of the bog, but it disappeared very quickly.
I whisper to the rest of the group, guys, we're being watched.
Okay, I would immediately like to sidle off to the side of the group and start sneaking in bushes or behind trees and stuff, just so the party is always like behind a tree compared to me, kind of thing.
Yeah, fine.
And I move
maybe...
to the side of them.
Is there maybe a dry patch of ground where I could safely drop the giant sack of books I'm carrying?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna do that, just in case I need to fight.
I just keep casually walking.
Okay, your path goes.
Oh, we keep walking. Okay, in that case I don't drop the books. But I'm just saying, if I have to drop the sack of books into the swamp, I'm gonna straight up kill a bitch.
Okay.
Which I might just do anyway.
Yeah. Your path that you're currently on, the safest path that the Dexter, I think, is navigating you through, would lead past the patch of bog that there appears to be something in. Are you still going to go straight past it, or are you going to go further away from it.
So wait, what's, like, what can I see, basically?
Okay, so we're next to an area that looks kind of dangerous, and we could take a slightly longer route around it, is what you're saying?
Yeah.
I'll walk around it.
Long route or short route is the decision?
And I say long route, because we don't know what that is, so I say we go the long route.
Yeah, I think we should go around it as well. If only because then maybe I don't have to drop the books into the swamp. It would make me pretty mad, just saying.
Okay, we take the long route, and I want to keep the dangerous area, like, behind a tree, so that I'm always sort of peeking at it from cover.
Yeah, that's fine. So you're staying slightly behind the party, observing, having a quick sneak at that. Okay.
I am scouting.
Yeah. Could you take a hide check?
Absolutely. As soon as I find my stealth button. Oh dear.
Okay.
I step on a giant pile of snappy twigs.
Oh, come
just
on.
A pile there
isn't
that
bad.
You just step on immediately.
Right. Any problem? You...
It's almost a critical fail, though.
Okay, the party goes past the bog. Nothing happens. Are you going to catch up somewhere? Are you slowly moving along, keeping the good distance away from them?
I think I'll just keep up with them, kind of thing. But
okay.
Always keeping a distance.
Yeah, that's fine. Could I have another perception check?
Perception, go.
24. Yep. Okay. After about 5 minutes after this happened, you're still moving along through the bog. You can see a pair of large frog-like eyes looking at you from behind you.
How big are the eyes?
Yeah. How big are they?
Large.
Oh dear.
Run.
Did you say frog-like?
Yeah.
I don't think I've got any knowledge skills at all. No. Bollocks. I can't even try to figure out what it is. Okay. I think I'm just going to speed up after the party and let them know.
Okay.
So, yeah. If I need to make any checks.
No, that's fine.
Okay. So, party, you now know that there is a pair of eyes following us.
So what did you say to us?
There's a large pair of frog-like eyes sitting in a bush away from you.
Can I start running? You
guys are quite a way away from it. It's just Slane who was keeping an eye on something or being kept an eye on.
Yeah, I still run. I just walk really quickly or something like on along those lines.
Yep. With everyone following you, dragging large amounts of books.
Yeah. Walk really quickly or run-ish. A slow jog, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I believe there's such a thing as hustling.
Yeah.
Which means you, have to do, an endurance check or something.
Oh, god damn it.
Only if you do it for really long. I'm not sure if we're gonna have to run for that long, you know.
That's a good point.
Yeah, and after a few minutes of moving, you can't see anything behind you. You couldn't hear anything from anything following you.
Okay, good.
Anything that you're doing, or just continue along?
No, just continue.
Okay. After about 4 hours of walking through the bog, you eventually can see the a clearing in the distance. The bog is finishing and you've got green fields. According to the map, you should be very, very close to the manor.
Awesome.
After another hour of walking through this, You can see the small road, which is a small sort of dirt track, which is marked on your map, and it leads you up to the Old Moor Road. And as promised, a lonely lantern burns in the upper story of the three-bedroom house.
Yes.
There's very little sign of habitation other than this one lamp. It's been old, but fairly well looked after. It's a large and imposing silhouette that's alone on the hill. Painted a dark green and surrounded by barbed wrought iron fencing, nothing about this place seems inviting or safe. Still, you have been asked to go there, and it's a lot nicer than being kept in a prison.
Oh, definitely.
Okay, does it look like anyone's been there recently?
There's no obvious signs, there's no tracks leading up to the house.
Just the lantern, then?
The lantern in the window, yeah, other than that it appears to be completely deserted.
Are we inside yet? Sorry.
No, so you're walking up the dirt path to the
house.
Can I just swing around the house? Like, just swing around it, just walk around it, just to see what's behind it?
Yep. As you move around, a lady appears at the door. It's the same one who appeared to be Gregory's girlfriend, I think it was. It's Theodora.
Greetings.
Dearest, you did take long enough. We're beginning to wonder if you have made it. Ah, and you've brought your friends. That's good. The master commands all of you to appear before him. Before that, you must be made presentable. Slaves, she claps her hands. A dozen young, attractive men and women, all wearing very traditional servants' livery, appear quickly, their heads bowed. These people are guests, she commands. See them to their rooms. I want them cleaned, dressed, and refreshed quickly. There's something in that last word that sounds very much like a threat. Certainly the slaves take that and hustle quickly to perform their duties.
Fantastic.
So, you're led up into the house. The accommodations are comfortable and the slaves are silent and efficient. There are fresh clothes, perfectly sized to each of you. And you each have a separate room. Grumblejack is also given a room.
that's nice of them.
Yeah,
good for him.
I want to take a bath.
Yeah, that's fine. The servant just nods at you and scampers away, and a bath is prepared for you.
Yeah, I have a bath as well.
Yeah.
Yes, seeing how we just tracked through pretty much a swamp. Yeah. I'm gonna do that as well.
Yeah.
And before it's ready, I sure hope there's like a bookcase in the room, because I'm gonna start stacking out the books, like before the bath is ready.
There's a couple of tables and things. There's already a few books in the room. On various topics that you've been interested in the past. In fact, there's a couple of books that you've actually been wanting to get your hands on for a while.
That's pretty nice.
You also each receive a huge plate of hot, delicious food, fresh water, and glasses of wine.
The
glass of wine has been mixed with healing herbs, and it's the equivalent of a potion of cure light wounds. So if you've got any hit points that you haven't recovered yet, you can gain 1d8 plus a few.
Sweet. I believe I'm at full health.
Yeah, me too.
And I never actually got hurt.
Yeah, I'm at full health, I think.
I'm good.
I think I should be at full health, don't I?
Yeah, think most people are. I think everyone recovered a load of health points last session.
Yeah. Because
they have 2 days of resting.
Grumblejack probably needs it.
Nah, he's full.
You healed him. He's not quite full, but you did hit. I think you spent an entire day of healing things on him, but even then, he's not quite full.
Okay, fair enough. So I'm gonna take a bath, Take a look at the books and then scarf down all the food offered.
Yeah, I'll take a look at the books in my room as well. See what there is.
There's not too many books in your room, but there's just sort of a couple of things that you might be interested in. It's very clear from the way your room is laid out that these people know who you are. They've done their research.
Great.
So so if they know who we are, then what would be in each other's rooms, if you know what I mean? What? Like, if they know Gregory is a necromancer, when they put interesting things there, if you know.
Yeah, so there'll be there's interesting dissections, animals of all sort of weird crap that you're into is in your room. Nothing particularly expensive, just things to.
So does that mean there's an altar to Asmodeus in mine?
Yes. Yep.
There won't be an altar for mine.
No, but there'll be a symbol of a holy symbol of, I've forgotten his name, but that god that you worship.
Yeah, I'll take that then.
Yeah.
I just bucket it.
Hey, you know that thing that we got at the start that helped us get out? There was a symbol of Asmodeus in that, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Yes. Yep.
Could I have that? Yeah. Like, if no one else wants it.
Oh, yeah.
No, go ahead, man. Sure, take it.
Alright, cool.
So far, you've only seen a small amount of the house so far, but you're guessing that they're pretty well off for symbols of Asmodeus. The house is full of them. As soon as from the outside it looks completely deserted, no one's been here in years. As soon as you get inside, that changes. It's very comfortable, and it's very obviously a house dedicated to the worship of Asmodeus. After a couple of hours of getting washed, having something to eat, Teodora comes back. Greetings, dearest. Are you now ready to see the master?
Sure.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, let's go, bitch.
I'm quite curious to who you are referring to. Who is your master?
We'll see soon enough.
He wishes to introduce him himself to you.
Yeah, it makes sense.
You can tell me.
He's got a way with words, I think. He would prefer to himself.
Oh, really? Lead the way.
Teodora leads you to a beautifully appointed and richly decorated large wooden staircase covered with exotic tapestries. Sitting in a leather high-backed chair is a devilishly handsome fellow who smiles as you enter. I believe, he says, you're the first to ever escape from Brandaskar prison. Well done. Of course, you had a little help from the outside, he says. But enough with pleasantries. You must be curious why I've helped you. Rest assured, this is no random act of altruism. I have brought you here for a reason. My name is Cardinal Andrastus Thorn. I am the last High Priest of Asmodeus left on the island of Talangard.
I immediately kneel.
The Prince of Nessus was rightly revered alongside the other great powers. Now, the King of Talangard has become who wish to destroy any religion that does not bow to their insipid sun god. For their blasphemy, I will see people who are imprisoned and condemned suffer. I understand what you went through. I have faced it myself. He pulls up the sleeve of his robe to reveal his own runic F brand. I am going to burn Talangard to the ground, and from the ashes I will build a new nation that knows its rightful master. I cannot do this alone. I seek servants worthy of our infernal father's majesty. Have I found them in you? He rises, and his eyes flash with hellfire and divine purpose. Join me. Serve me well in this holy endeavour, and I will raise you up in the eyes of gods and men. I will make you princes of the new Talengard. Today, swear fealty to me and to Asmodeus. Put aside forgiveness, and I will give you vengeance. Put aside mercy, and be made powerful. Put aside peace, and become my harbingers of war. What say you? Will you swear your allegiance, or will you burn with the rest of the blind fools?
Actually, I say,
my allegiance is already sworn to Asmodeus.
My allegiance is... Well, I can help you, but I still serve my god. Damn, I forgot his name. But I won't betray my god, but I can help you. I don't mind swearing allegiance.
Charon, I think it is. Charon?
Charon?
Yeah, it was Charon.
Charon? Charon? Yeah, okay. I won't...
Charon, yeah.
Yeah, Charon, yeah. I won't get rid of my allegiance to Charon, my god. Though I don't mind helping you out, or I don't mind doing any of that, but I will not get rid of my allegiance.